Yes, good morning class. Welcome to your social studies. So, in the earlier chapter, we have discussed about our earth and solar system. In that previous video, we have discussed about the sun and the moon. And now we are going to discuss about the planets and the solar system. In earlier, we have discussed that, you know, the moon changes its shape daily or regular basis because the moon revolves around the earth, and due to the revolution of earth around the sun, it is possible for having day and night. So we have discussed about the different phases of moon. Then we have discussed about the different type of gases which are found in our atmosphere. Then we have discussed that, you know, sun having its own heat and light, that's why sun is also called a star. But then we have discussed the question that if sun is a star, then why the sun is more bright than the stars which appear in the night. So the distance for the answer for that question was distance. Due to the distance between the sun and the stars, we came to know about the difference between the brightness and heatness of sun and stars. So now we are going to start with the next topic of our chapter, which is planet. So what are planets? The bodies which do not have their heat and light are known as planets, as they get heat and light from the sun, because planets are the part of solar system. Earth is also a planet in which we all live. Here you can see is a solar system in which sun is the head of the solar system. The different planets are found on the solar system according to their distance. As you can see that Mercury is the planet which is very near to the sun. Then after Mercury, it's Venus, Earth, the planet where we live. Then Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. So those planets which are very near to the sun are known as the inner planets, and the planets which are very far away from the sun are known as outer planets. So according to the distance of the planets from the sun, we have categorized the planets into two categories. One category is inner planet and other category is outer planet. Here you can see that there are the different planets shown in the solar system according to the distance they have from the sun. So here it is our planet Earth. So Earth is the only planet which have air, water and land. That's why the life and the main thing, which is the presence of oxygen, which is very important for the survival. So that's why from all these planet, Earth is only a unique planet in which life exists due to the presence of these main components, land, air and water. Right, so now after that we are going to discuss about the constellation, that what are constellations. So constellations are a group of stars which are found in the sky during the night time. So constellation means when the group of stars collectively form a pattern, so that patterns are known as constellation. And there are different type of constellation found in the sky during the night time, like Saptarishi, which is a collection of seven stars. Then there is a star known as pole star, and other name for pole star is north star, because the pole star tells us the direction of north. That's why the name given to the pole star is north star. As the position of the star is fixed in the sky, so with the help of the pole star, it is very easy to locate the north direction. Now we are going to discuss about the different asteroids and meteoroids which are found in the solar system. They are also the part of solar system. We will discuss about these one by one. Yes, students, moving to the next topic, which is asteroids. So what are asteroids? Asteroids are the numerous tiny bodies which move around the sun, and these asteroids are found between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. So these asteroids are found between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. Some scientists are in the view that these asteroids are the part of a planet which are exploded many years back. So that's why, you know, due to the explosion of planet, maybe these asteroids are a part of the planet which is exploded many years ago between Mars and Jupiter. So that's the reason why the asteroids are found between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. Now moving to the last topic of this chapter, which is meteoroids. So meteoroids are a small pieces of rocks which move around the sun, and these meteoroids sometime came near to the earth. Like if they came very near to the earth, they dropped down from the atmosphere, and due to the friction present in the air, they burned up and we can see only a flash of light. But sometime these meteoroids do not get heated up and burnt, and they came into the earth and form a hollow. So meteoroids can be burnt with the friction of air, and if they burnt with the friction of air, we can see only a flash of light. But if these meteoroids does not, you know, heat it up or burst, then they create a hollow on the surface of earth. And now the last thing that we are going to discuss in this chapter is about Akash Ganga. Maybe some of the students have learned about this Akash Ganga previous in their chapters of social studies. So what is Akash Ganga? Akash Ganga or a Milky Way, the other name for Akash Ganga is a Milky Way. So Milky Way means, you know, when there are billion of stars collected together, they have, you know, different type of gases, and you know, they have different type of clouds. So these million stars form a white, you know, whitish broad band like a structure which is known as Milky Way, and the other name is Akash Ganga. So there are millions of such galaxies which form the universe. As there is no, you know, proper information about the universe, that how big is our universe, scientists are still, you know, understanding the different concepts about the universe. The only thing that we know is that we are a part of universe, and later on when different, you know, inventions are being made for the information of the universe, we will all let know about the new information regarding the inventions or his researches of scientists. So this was your chapter about the earth and the solar system, in which we have discussed that, you know, the solar system consists of different planets, consists of constellations, consists of sun, then it consists of moon. So I hope you all understand the different concepts of the solar systems which include in our earth and make our earth a unique planet. Thank you students, and have a nice day.